Hello, 3D printing friends. Recently, my buddy Jim over at the Edge of Tech put out a video responding to Angus, Maker's Muse, as part of an invitation to answer 5 questions with the intention of highlighting 3D printing on YouTube. And at the end of it, Jim called me out.
I'm gonna hit up Brian Vines to do a video. I can't wait to see your responses.
So today on the BV3D channel, I'll be doing exactly that right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. Okay, so today I'm answering Maker's Muse's 5 questions about 3D printing. And after I go through these, I want to know what your answers would be. So make your own video and include the 3D printing on YouTube hashtag. And if you don't feel comfortable on camera, then please light up the comments with your answers and share this video with your friends to see what they'd say too. Okay, here we go. Question number 1. When did you first hear about 3D printing? So, I first heard about 3D printing sometime back in early 2011. There was a segment on a National Geographic show called Known Universe where they 3D printed a crescent wrench using a Z Corporation powder-based printer. It was a fully functional, adjustable print-in-place tool, and I thought that was just cool as heck. So that planted the seeds of my fascination with 3D printing. But at the time, the technology was still enormously expensive. As time went on, prices dropped, until finally, in the middle of 2017, after watching a lot of 3D printing videos on YouTube, many of which were 3D printing nerd videos, I bought my first printer, a Monoprice Maker Select Plus for $399. For the time, it was a pretty advanced machine, with a decent 200 by 200 by 180mm build volume, direct drive extruder, and a touchscreen. It was pretty easy to assemble, although I did have a lot of learning to do. One of the first things being that leveling the bed did not involve a bubble level. I think within an hour of having it unboxed, I had it printing, and that leads into the next question. Question number 2. What was the first thing you 3D printed? The first thing I 3D printed was this, a tiny, comfy-looking chair that was one of the files on the printer's SD card. When I selected the file to print, I actually had no idea what it was going to be, because the 4 pre-sliced files were just named 1, 2, 3, and 4. But by pure chance, the one I picked was the comfy chair, so that's the one I printed first. By the standards of modern printers, it looks okay-ish, and maybe not the best, and it took a while to print. I don't remember exactly how long it took, but it was probably a couple hours. But it was my first print, and I thought it was pretty cool watching the printer print it and trying to figure out what in the world it was going to be when it grew up. Given how disorganized I can be sometimes, I'm surprised I still have it. Apparently, I thought well enough of it that I kept it safe on a shelf all these years just so I could show it to you. Okay, on to the next. Question number 3. Do you view 3D printing as a hobby or as a tool, and why? Well, I see it kind of like woodworking. I can do basic level woodwork, like making pull-out shelves for the bottom cabinets in my kitchen or building a side table. In the same way, I can do basic 3D modeling in Tinkercad and then print the resulting models. To me, these are both enjoyable things to do and fun ways to pass the time, and so they could be classified as a hobby. But at the same time, both can solve problems, like how to get more usable storage space in the kitchen cabinets or replacing missing rubber feet on folding tables. So there's no reason 3D printing can't be both a hobby and a tool. I guess it all depends on how you 3D print, or why. If you like printing decorative objects to place around your house, like holiday decorations, that seems more hobby-ish to me. But at the same time, if you have commercial licenses for the models you print, or you design them yourself, and you're printing things to sell, then 3D printing is a tool that you're using to earn a living. So my official answer is 3D printing is both. I see it as a hobby, and it can be a tool. Question number 4. What is the best 3D printer? Now, Jim's version of this question was exactly that. What's the best 3D printer? And for that, I think Admiral Akbar summed it up best.
It's a trap!
But maybe the correct answer is like the one for what's the best camera. So in the same way that the best camera is the one you have with you, you might say that the best 3D printer is the one you have, assuming it's in working condition. If you need a part printed now, then the printer you currently have is going to be the printer best able to handle the job. Again, subject to certain constraints, like that the printer can print the material the model needs to be printed in, and the model fits on the printer. All that aside, though, I didn't have enough context for the question to give a good answer. So for clarification, I watched Angus's video, and he specifically says, this is not a trap question. What is the best 3D printer according to you and your experiences? Well, my experiences with the Bamboo Lab printers, the X1 Carbon, the A1, and the A1 Mini, have been great. These are the printers I turn to when I want to print something for myself, or if I'm showing off prints like in my recent Halloween 3D prints video. For a new user, the under $200 Bamboo Lab A1 Mini is an absolutely stunning machine for the money. Full automatic calibration, direct drive, super quiet, fast, easy to use touchscreen, and you can either add the 4-spool AMS light to it later or get it as a combo when you buy the printer and do multicolor or multi-material printing. And yes, you can get a printer for less, but generally speaking, printers that are well below the A1 Mini in price are going to take more work to get them going and get them dialed in. So for a beginner who wants to jump right in and just slice, send, and print without having to worry too much about calibration or trying to make the printer work, I'd say go with the Bamboo Lab A1 Mini. But that's just my opinion, of course, and based on my experiences. And on the topic of beginners, here's question number 5. What is your number one tip for beginners? Okay, that's a good question. I would say take your time, do some Google searches, and watch lots of YouTube videos about the specific printer that you got or are about to get. And the point of that is so you get a variety of perspectives on the printer. While sometimes those of us in the 3D printing YouTube space independently come to a consensus about a particular printer, it's more often the case that we all come at a printer from slightly different angles, and we have different expectations of what any given printer should be able to do and whether it does in fact live up to those expectations. And our expectations and inherent biases can color our perception of a printer. I'm not immune to that, but I do my best. So try to gather as much information as you can before you take the plunge. And also look for a good support forum for your chosen printer. Some printer manufacturers have good support infrastructure and some don't. But if you're having a problem with a printer, the first place to turn is the manufacturer's support team. If they can't solve the issue, there are a lot of different user-based support communities for different printers, and you can turn to those. Try to do searches or research in the user-based support forums before asking a question, because someone else may already have run into the same problem and it's already been answered. Some online communities get super cranky when seeing the same question asked over and over, but others are more tolerant of that, and their members can either answer directly or point you to the post where the question was already asked and answered. But that's pretty much the tip. Do your research so you know what you're getting into. So those are my answers to the questions, and I'm going to tag Chris Kersey of Kersey Fabrications. He's been working on some amazing Iron Man stuff, and Garrett from 3D Print Farm. I miss your videos, buddy. Okay, you two, it's your turn. Answer these questions, include the hashtag 3D printing on YouTube, tag another maker, and help keep this going. And to you, my 3D printing friends, as I said at the beginning, let me know in the comments what your answers to the questions are, or even make your own video and upload it with the 3D printing on YouTube hashtag. And also, click that hashtag to explore other people's responses. Thank you for watching. Thanks to Angus for this brilliant idea. Thanks to Jim for looping me in. And big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.